So today we will talk about the repo rate, reverse repo rate and the bank rate. Recently the Monetary Policy Committee meeting held in which the 5 members, out of the 6 members actually the 5 members in the favor of the accommodative stance of the RBI and 1 member is against it. So briefly we will talk about what is the accommodative stance. Accommodative stance is basically whenever is the measure is taken by the RBI is needed for maintaining the growth as well as keeping inflation in check. This is what do you mean by the accommodative stance. And in which Monetary Policy Committee there is a rate of reverse repo rate and the repo rate and the bank rate is remain unchanged and that's why there is a accommodative stance. So let's talk about. As I told you why news recently the RBI decided to keep all the rates unchanged, repo rate at 4%, reverse repo rate at 3.3% and bank rate 4%. So you need to understand the concept and actually question right from the concept. So you need to understand the concept. So if you talk about the concept then remember that this is the other banks and this is the main central bank of India. RBI is also known as the central bank of India. If you talk about the repo rate and the reverse repo rate, then remember that whenever the RBI lends money to the other banks, any kind of bank, scheduled banks, rural bank, infrastructure, NABARD, anything like bank, then that is known as the repo rate. And in which what happened, obviously if they are taking the money from the RBI, then they have to pay the interest to the RBI. This is the concept, remember that. So whenever the RBI lends money to the bank, other banks known as the repo rate, on that money which is lending by the RBI, other banks has to pay the interest. So look at this simple example. So we are, as a retailer, take any amount of credit from the any bank. So we have to pay interest. This is the similar concept here. RBI is lending, then these banks have to pay interest to this. Is known as the repo rate. It is as simple as. And remember that monetary policy, this comes under this. So these are the tools of monetary policy. If you talk about the monetary policy tool, then the statutory liquidity ratio means certain amount you have to need keep in check in the banks. And similarly in the cash reserve ratio, which is more or less similar, but here is the gold also came. Here you can only the cash. So this is very, very important. If you talk about there are the open market operation, reverse repo and reverse repo rate and the bank rate. So these are the monetary tools. What do you mean by and what is the main purpose of the monetary tool is to maintain the liquidity. If there is a excess liquidity in the market, then RBI has the responsibility to suck out the excess liquidity from the market. And if there is a lack of liquidity in the market, then RBI has to lend more and more money to the borrower. So to maintain the liquidity in the market. And remember that in these all things is done to keep inflation in check, which is 4% plus minus 2% deviation as well as the growth. So this is very, very important. As I have told you, what is the repo rate? Now what happened? The RBI issues the some securities like the government securities, so popularly known as the government security or any kind of security which can be under the open market operation. And as you know, recently the operation twist in which RBI pays the security of around the 10,000 to the other bank and then the RBI has to pay the interest. This is known as the operation twist. So this is the similar case here. What happened? RBI issues the security and these other banks actually subscribe to that security and now RBI has the responsibility to pay interest to this bank because they borrow the security. Is known as the reverse repo rate. Remember that. This is whole concept you need to remember. You need to remember the basically the interest. If they are taking, if they are the RBI is giving, then these banks has to pay interest. And if these RBI is issuing the securities, then this bank is subscribing, then these banks or RBI has to pay these banks interest. So this is known as the reverse repo rate. So reverse rate, here is the reverse is going on. That's why there is the reverse repo rate. This is the concept. Why this is doing? To maintain the liquidity in the market. If there is any excess liquidity, then RBI has the responsibility to suck out the excess liquidity. If there is a lack of liquidity, then there will be a RBI has to lend the money to these other banks and these other banks will lend to the borrower and that's why there will be liquidity maintenance in the market. This is the whole concept as I have told you. So if you talk about the monetary policy tools, these are the modern monetary policy tools. As I have told you, what is the main purpose is to maintain the liquidity in the market. So now let's talk about the bank rate. It is a small concept. Remember that it is a way to lend short-term funds to banks. Remember that on which the RBI charges the interest. So this is also a kind of monetary tool which is used by the RBI to access liquidity, to suck out the excess liquidity or to increase the liquidity. So remember that. Bank rate actually increased for decreasing the borrowings from the RBI is one of the tools. So remember that whenever the RBI thinks that the bank are more actually asking for borrowing, then what that the RBI increases the bank rate to discourage the borrowing, especially from the RBI. So whatever the amount the bank has, then they lend up to borrower. So neither pay interest to the RBI while lending to the borrowers and take interest from them. So remember that, and that's why they increase the bank rate. Bank rate discouraged for increasing the borrowing from the RBI. So here what happened whenever there is a excess liquidity in the market, so whatever actually RBI discouraged the bank rate and to encourage the borrowing. So now the bank rate has to pay the interest to the RBI, and that's why the excess liquidity will suck out from the market. So there is a reverse concept, just like the repo rate and the reverse repo. But remember that these all are the monetary tools, is the very, very important. Remember that if you talk about the Monetary Policy Committee, then Monetary Policy Committee is a 6-member committee. Remember that, and headed by the RBI governor. And after that, there are the 5 members, 3 from the government side and 3 from the RBI, including the RBI governor as a head. So remember that. And what is the main job? Main job is to actually define the interest rate and keep the interest rate time to time change, remain unchanged, or whatever time is required. Main is to benchmark interest rate has to be decided by the RBI. And remember that there is, and one of the main important task of the Monetary Policy Committee is that to make the or to maintain the inflation rate of 4% plus minus 2% here and there. So this is the all about. Thank you guys, hope you like this video.